Lecture. Today we are going to learn about the mathematical expectation and variance of random variable. This is the topic under which we are going to learn about the movement generating function. If you remember what we have done in the last lecture, we have seen what are the rules for calculating the expectation and how to calculate the expectation. We have also learned what is the formula for the mean, that is E. In bracket, we have to write down x, and we have learned that the formula is summation of x into px if it is discrete, and if it is continuous, then it is integral of x fx dx, where fx and px denote the probability mass function and probability density function. Correct? So, whenever we have continuous data, we will have the value of the probability density function, and in order to find out the expected value, that is the mean, we have taken integral of x fx dx. Similarly, in case of discrete, we have the probability mass function, and there we have taken the summation over the x multiplied by the probability values. Correct? Similarly, we have calculated regarding the variance, and we have learned two formulas. One we have learned when directly I have to take x minus mu whole square expectation. So again, it will be just replace x by this x minus mu whole square in case of discrete or continuous in the formula, and we'll get an answer. And another formula we have learned as a shortcut formula, that is e of x square, in bracket we have e of x square minus of e x whole square. So hope so you're getting it, because we have replaced e x as mu also, which is our mean. So this is all we have learned. Today we have to see what are the concepts of the movement, what is the meaning of movements, and how we can generate movements from the expectation, and what is the movement generating formula. So if we start with, this is what we have just revised totally. Like the expected value, Ex, Ex square, Ex cube and Exr are called the movement. If we revise what we have learned, already we have learned that mean mu is equal to Ex, expected value of x, we call it as mean. It means already if we are saying Ex, Ex square, Ex cube up to Exr, all are the movements. So what it is, we have already learned about the first movement, and we have already learned about what the variance is. Variance we have taken E of x square minus E x whole square. This is what we have, mu. Correct? And here we have written that already we have learned this, which are sometimes difficult to find. So we have some special function called as movement generating function that helps the mean and variance of the random variable in a simpler way. Correct? So this is what we call as movement generating function. Movement generating function is those functions. They are the functions that will generate the movements. And what movements are? The first movement is mean. The second movement helps us to find out the variance that we have seen. That if we have this E of x square, then taking this and the difference of E x whole square, we can have the variance. So the first movement itself is mean, mu. The second movement is helping us to find out the variance. It's not variance, but it's help us in finding out the variance. The third movement, if we discuss what it is, it gives me the skewness of the data. And if I discuss what skewness is, so whenever we have the data which has the extreme values, either very small or very large. For example, if I take that most of the students in my class are of age, average, if I talk about you students, might be you are of age 18 to 20 near about, correct? But might be possible, as we have seen, some of the students are coming from the QIP program in which they have to enhance their qualifications. So sometime we have the students of very large age also. So might be we have the students of age, suppose we have students of age 18, 20, 19 and so on, but there is one student of age 61, let me take, correct? So if I have to calculate the mean, then the mean from this should be a very small number, but due to the 61, the mean is going to be raised. So what this is, the data is skewed. Skewed means having the outliers, we can say, having a very great or very small value. And sometimes you might have seen that some of the kids at the small age are joining the students of the intermediate and 10th standard. They are giving the exam due to some God gifts. So in that case is also we can say when the age is very less as compared to the other students. So that student is acting as an outlier. Right? So this is the meaning of skewness. So what E x cube is, it gives me the measure of skewness. Similarly, if I write on E x 4, it gives me the kurtosis. Correct? So here, whatever expected value we are calculating for x are, they are meant for one or other statistical tool. So this is what we are going to learn today. These are the moments. Now we are going to focus upon what moment generating functions are for both random as well as continuous variable, and let's see how to calculate it. I have just given you a summary type of thing that what are the benefits of calculating moments. Here we have the same thing. First moment is Ex mu. The second moment is Ex square. Third moment Ex cube. And fourth moment Ex 4. Mean is Ex mu. Variance is sigma square, which is E of x minus mu whole square. What are the formula we are using now for variance? It is Ex square minus mu square that we can get from here also. And if I talk about what is the difference between this moment and this moment, so this moment is uncentered, means it is about origin, and this is about mean. This is the difference. Here we can say these are the moment about mean. When you will open your book, then you can see there are two things they have mentioned. One is moment about origin, and another thing is moment about mean. Moment about mean means we are going to take E and in bracket x minus mu square, mu cube or mu 4. And in general, if I have to write down, moment about mean means we are going to take expectation of x minus mu raised to power r. Right? So this is the formula for the moment about mean. Where is mean? This mu is representing the mean. And if this is 0, if we are talking about the center origin, so it becomes E, and in between we have x r. Sorry, I think here it must be capital X. I have written small x. Huh? So this is what we have, and here we have depicted. Okay, one student have joined us. Let me go back. Till then, you can just focus upon what the things we have locations here. So here we have the formulas for the mean, variance, skewness and kurtosis. Now the next thing is, one thing we have seen that using the expected value or the expectation we can calculate the moments. The another thing is how to write on the moment generating function that will help us in order to find out the moment. So here we are saying that the moment generating function of a random variable x, we are talking about origin, having the probability function fx. If we are talking about a random variable with the probability function fx, then how we can give the moment generating function? The moment generating function is represented by capital M x t. Again, some of the authors have used here t, some can use s. It depends from author to author what they are representing, but most of the time in most of the books you will get here t. But you have not to confuse if in exams we are getting some different variable, correct? X is a variable, random variable what we are talking about, and T is just a notation for a variable that we are going to use in the expectation. And what it represent, this is the moment generating function given by expected value of E. E is exponential of e raised to power Tx. E raised to power Tx, I think we are aware of what exponential is, exp. So here we have expected value of E raised to power Tx. This is the moment generating function. And there is one condition also, some of the authors have emphasized. I've emphasized a lot on the condition also, but normally we ignore while calculating. The moment generating function of x exists if there is a positive constant a such that mxt is finite for all t belongs to this range. This is a condition that told us that when the movement generative function will exist. We are saying MGF or movement generative function exists if there is a positive constant A, and a positive constant we are talking about that MXT value is a finite value. Obviously, it exists, it means its value must be finite. So this is what we are saying, that if T lies in a range minus A to A, then for all this MXT value must be finite, then we will say that movement generative function exists. Correct. So you have to also focus upon that at least you must know that there is some condition for the existence of the movement generating function. Correct. And what we have learned till now in all the examples of expectation, we have taken expectation of x or x square or x cube or some polynomial. Correct. Here what we are saying, all the formulas that we have learned yesterday as a properties have to be taken care of, and we are going to calculate this. The movement generating function is given by expected value of t raised to power tx. Correct. So let's see how we are going to work for it. And here we are saying, if x is discrete random variable, we have to learn for both discrete as well as continuous. First, let us start with a discrete one. Correct. Okay, one more thing here we can see on the slide, we have written that the movement generating function, why it is named so? Because it is used to find the movements of the distribution. And with it, till now we have not started with the distribution. I think in your fourth unit or third, I'm not sure, I just forgot. Whatever the third or fourth coming unit is, in which we have to learn the distribution. In our course, we have the binomial distribution, Poisson distribution, normal distribution. So for all these three, we are going to calculate the movement generating function in their own chapters. Correct? In their own lectures, we are going to calculate the movement generating function, because as we are going to learn what is their mean, variance, standard deviation, there also we will learn about the movement generating function. So here, we are not going to take the examples of those distributions, but we will learn them as soon as they will appear in the lectures. So here we are saying that whenever some distribution is there. Now what is distribution? I think we are clear about. Already we know about the probability distribution. So it is the same thing. Whenever we have some distribution, for that we have to calculate the movements. So movements can be calculated by the help of movement generating function. That's why it's known as movement generating, because it helps us to generate the movements. Correct. Now let's start with what is the expansion of e raised to power tx. If you are aware of this exponential function, normally we have learned as ex. No? So ex is 1 plus x square by factorial 2, x cube by factorial 2, up to xn by factorial n, and it is an infinite series. So here what we have done, what the general formula we have is, we have taken small x as t into capital X. If I write down here so that you will not be confused, in general, in the mathematics, we have the expansion of Ex. Sometimes you can write down as a general form as E theta also. Let me write down.
Is this Taylor series, ma'am?
This is not a Taylor series. This is the Taylor series expansion of exponential.
Okay.
Taylor series actually is one series, but here whatever the expansions are, it is coming from the formula of Taylor series. So we have Ex is 1 plus
means Taylor series is used to find the formula.
Yes.
Okay.
So this is what we normally say. This is the Taylor series expansion, means when we have to calculate this formula, in calculating this formula, Taylor series has been used. So this is the formula we have, that exponential of x is given by 1 plus x square by factorial 2 plus x cube by factorial 3. Here what we are writing out, we have to write down e raised to power tx. So if I replace small x by tx, it is 1 plus, in place of x we have tx, then tx whole square by factorial 2, tx whole cube by factorial 3, and so on. So we have written it like this. Now if you revise, what is MXT? MXT is a movement generating function given by expected value of e raised to power tx. So what we have to do, we have to take expectation of this expression on both the sides. Means taking e here and e here. If I implement E here on both the sides, what we will get? As we have done, the expected value of 1. 1 is a constant. So expected value of 1 is 1, the constant. Next we have is E of Tx. So T is again working as a constant because x is a random variable we are focusing upon. So it becomes T outside into Ex. Similarly, T square, Ex square by factorial 2, T cube, Ex cube by factorial 3, and so on. Hope that so this is clear, because already yesterday I have emphasized more upon the properties, because all the properties have to be utilized here. So if you have done for that, I think there is no confusion regarding all these things. Correct? So here we have these expressions coming as this whole expression. And what this ex, ex square, ex cube, we have already learned that e, x, r represent the rth movement. Correct? This was given in the first slide. Then e, x is my first movement. E, x square is my second movement. Ex cube is the third movement, and if it is exn, then it is the nth movement. Correct? So what we are getting is, we are getting the movements, whatever the coefficients of t is, its first movement, coefficient of t square, m2, second movement, coefficient of t cube by factorial 3, third movement, and so on. So here we can say this mn is the nth movement, and on differentiating mxt, this mxt I time with respect to t, for t is equal to 0, we will calculate the ith moment about origin. One way is we are looking for the coefficient of tn. Coefficient of tn by n factorial is my mn. This is one thing to say. Another thing which we can say is, if I differentiate this moment generating function, let's see how we are differentiating and what we will get. Let me remove all the ink again. So what we are saying here, differentiating mxt, the moment generating function I times, and putting t is equal to 0, we will generate ith moment about origin. Okay? About origin, what we have discussed is all about origin. No? So it means if I differentiate it once, this is my mxt. If I take d by dt, what I will get? D by dt, if I do of mxt, 1 will give me 0, t will give me 1. So here I will get m1. And in all other terms, here I will get 2t, 3t square, and so on, I will get t value. And if I put t is equal to 0, all other terms will lead to 0. And the only term which will left is m1. Hope so you're getting it. Correct? So this is what is the meaning, that if I differentiate, here you can see, here we have elaborated, that if I differentiate movement generating function one time with respect to t and take t is equal to 0, then what it will give me? It will give me m1, which is the first movement. Is it clear? From here you can see, this is mxt, the whole expression. If I differentiate it, 1 will be turned to 0, this t will become 1, and all others have t. And if I put t as 0, I will get only em1, which is the first expected value. And similarly, on differentiating twice, I will get the second moment, and so on. That's why we called it as a movement generating function. It will generate the moment on differentiating it and taking the t as is equal to 0. Correct? So this is what the discrete random variable movement generating function can be discussed as. So it is the same thing here, and sometimes it is written as a proposition that if a random variable possesses a moment generating function mxt, then the nth moment of x denoted by mu xn, or we can write on mn, correct, exists and is finite. Furthermore, it is given by p of xn is equal to nth derivative of mxt with respect to t at t is equal to 0. Right. So here I have written it separately, because sometimes it is required to find out the
ma'am, movement. Anwar is asking to let him in.
Yeah, I see.
There was network problem. He also called me, ma'am. He also called me.
This
to tell you about
message,
that.
But still, I'm not getting the request from Anwar. There's no question.
he posted it on LP Live.
Might be, but I'm
Yeah,
not
I'm
getting
telling
to.
him. Okay,
Doesn't matter.
ma'am, okay.
Now I have taken a pause. Let me start with the attendance also. I think Lokesh is in. Lokesh, are you here?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay. Sairam, Mahendra, Arjun, Aniket, Anwar, and Himanshu. Any one of you have joined us, then let me know. Anwar is trying, so I can give attendance to him. Otherwise, all other are absent. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are absent out of 24. So this is what the proposition we have regarding the derivative of the moment generating function that gives us the moments, correct? The nth moment, if we have to require, then what we have to do? We have to differentiate the moment generating function n times, and we have to take t is equal to 0. Another way that we have learned is I can take the coefficient of tn by n factorial, and this is also give me the nth moment, correct? So both are the ways. This is what we have. And if our x is a continuous random variable, what is the formula? Here the formula is minus infinity to infinity, because we are working with a continuous random variable. So it is minus infinity to infinity etx again. So you have to learn this main formula. When we are working with this discrete, we will have to use summation. When we are working with the continuous, it will be the integral. Integral minus infinity to infinity etx into fxx dx, where what is this fx? This is the probability density function. Correct? So this is what we have as a formula. And again, if I write down what is the expansion, so it will come in the same form, 1 plus dx plus t square x square by 2, and so on, tn x and n factorial into fx dx. And on integration and simplification, we will get what it is, the 1 plus t into m1, the first moment, t square by factorial 2 into m2 up to tn by n factorial mn. It is not finite, it is still continued, but we are looking till the nth moment. So whatever these coefficients are coming, these are the nth moment. Now we have the property as a linear transformation of random variable. What the property is saying, if a random variable x has a moment generating function mxt, this is the moment generating function of random variable x, then what is the what is the moment generating function of alpha x plus b, where alpha and beta obviously both are constant. So how we can write it down? We can write down, if this is the moment generating function mxt of x, then how we can write down? We can write down the moment generating function of alpha x plus beta t is equal to this. And how we can write it down? See here. Here we are saying, till now when we have worked for, here I think we have to elaborate from mxt. What we have learned that mxt is given by E of means the expectation of exponential of tx. This is what we have written. So if x is here, this we are talking about the expected value, oh sorry, the moment generating function of x, then we have written here expected value of E tx. And here if we have alpha x plus beta, it should be here. So we are replacing this x by alpha x plus beta. So in place of x, if I write on alpha x plus beta and in bracket t, it is equal to expected value of e raised to power in place of xt. What we have? we have alpha x plus beta into t. Correct. Now if we see what are the constant that should be outside, so we know here we have beta t. Means if I write down as a one more step, I can write down expected value of e raised to power alpha xt. This is how we can open the explanation, and plus e raised to power beta t. Sorry, it's into. This is product of this into this. And if we know this is a constant value and expected value of this will give me the same value, so it will lead to e raised to power beta t into expected value of e alpha xt. So this is how we are writing out that this is the moment generating function of alpha t. Correct. So this is how we have expanded that if we have x with the moment generating function mxt, then alpha x plus beta has the moment generating function given by the constant part is coming outside, beta t, e raised to power beta t constant, and it is the moment generating function of x alpha t. Correct. This x will be here, and in place of t we will have alpha t. So this is the rule for the linear transformation of random variable. But all this is in theory. In numericals, how we are going to work with? We are going to work with discrete or continuous random variable, and using the formulas that we have learned, we are going to calculate them. So here I have taken a script, a snapshot from an example. Here what we are saying, for each of the following random variable, we have one, we have discrete, and another we have uniform 0, 1. Uniform 0, 1 means here we are working with a continuous interval. Correct. We have to find out the moment generating function. Let us start with it. Okay, one more thing here. Till now when we have worked with the probability distribution and all these things, we have taken x and their probabilities as px. Here you can see here what we are saying. Here we are saying that the probability of k, here we have taken probability of k is equal to 1 by 3 when k is equal to 1, and probability, because we are working with that x is a random variable that can take two values. K means capital X can take two values, 1 and 2. This is how I can interpret it. And if we talk about what is the probability of taking any of these values, till now we have taken with small x, na? So here just they are representing by k. So it is the difference in the representation. Otherwise, things are same. Right? So what we are saying? We are saying the value is 1 by 3. And if what is the chance of taking value 2? So it is 2 by 3. So this is how we have given with the probability mass function. And what we are looking for, we have to find out the moment generating function. So can you start by yourself if I give you a hint? And I think already we are aware of moment generating function. We have learned as expected value of e tx. And what is etx? Etx means expected value of this. And what we have learned, it is summation of e tx into, because it is discrete, into their probabilities px. Okay. So just try to find out what is this. According to me, it's very simple. For value 1, we have this probability. So I can put x as 1 and use a probability, and then use an addition, and I will put x as 2 and take this probability and find out the value. So start working on it and let me know what is the value of this moment generating function. I'm coming back, just try to work on it. Yeah, I got an answer. Himanshu is saying 1/3 e raised to power s. And Himanshu, have you seen from the PPT? Because we have not used s. Huh? So let's wait for others to be done. And Himanshu, if you are looking for the answer from your PPT and giving me answer, then it's not good because you have to do by yourself. Huh? Because till
ma'am,
now,
no, ma'am.
Anji,
ma'am,
then how
done
you
by
are
myself. Ma'am,
yes,
I have
from
done
your
it my by
PPT,
my. Because ma'am, every day you give me PPT, na, ma'am, I will, ma'am, I will try to solve the questions, ma'am,
okay,
for
that's
math.
good. Okay, that's okay. But actually, till now we have used means in the discussions ETX, you know? And it is actually the same thing. Either you are using T or S, answer is correct.
T, ma'am, constant is when we can use A also.
Yeah, you can. Doesn't matter. It is the same thing. Correct. So if you have done, actually, that's why I have not turned to this next page because I know that there from the book where this has been written, they have written S. Until now in our discussion in all the formulas, because example I have taken from some other source. So, but normally means 90% of the time we used T as a variable for the moment generating function. So let's discuss how we have to write down. If I put X value, so here we have X as 1. So X is 1 means if you take X as 1, it becomes T.
1/3 to
the probability is coming as 1/3. Correct. This is a 1/3. Similarly, for the next value, of the random variable is 2. So here we have e raised to power 2t. If I put x as 2, it becomes e raised to power 2t into e. So probability is 2/3. So this is what we have, e raised to power 2t into 2/3. So we can take 3 as common. So we will have 1/3, and then we can write down in bracket et plus e raised to power 2t. So this is how we have to solve for the movement generating function if the probability function is given to us for the discrete random variable. This is how we have to solve it. Let's see what the solution is. This is the solution. Here they have used sx. We can use obviously any constant, but normally, as we have discussed, that normally teachers and most of the authors use t as a variable for expected value of x. And here we have seen the solution for the next one is also there. So the question was, we are getting y is a uniform random variable, and uniform random variable fonts we have given. A range 0 to 1, it means function is lying the value 0 to 1, and what the uniform distribution is from 0 to 1, it has the value 1, otherwise it is 0. This is how it is defined. So if I have to find out the moment generating function, what we have to do, we can say the moment generating function is given by E, and here we have used S, so it is ES, and the random variable notation is Y. And if I have to use the formula, it is 0 to 1 because it is continuous. Range is 0 to 1 in which it is 1, otherwise it is 0. So we will take this range 0 to 1, 1 into ESY, this dy. And if I integrate it, obviously it is ESY by S. And we have to take the limits from 0 to 1. It will give me ES minus 1 divided by S. So this is the answer for the continuous movement generating function. We have been provided with a distribution function, and from there we have calculated the value of the movement generating function for the continuous as well as discrete one. Hope so we are getting it. Here we have the next thing. We have already discussed. Let me come to this last point. It is just because I have taken an example, might be that's why I have added it again, but already we have discussed how we are going to do. We have seen that when we have expanded the series, then whatever is coming with t n by n factorial is our nth movement. Correct? So this is the same thing, that the kth movement of x is the coefficient of this sx by x factorial. Let me go back and show you from where we can say this. We have learned from here. There I have marked also that whatever is the coefficient of this tn by n factorial is our ex in the nth moment. So here also we have the same thing noted down as a definition, that the kth moment of x is the coefficient of sx by x factorial in the Taylor series of this moment generating function. Okay, and from here we can calculate whatever moment is required for the random variable. We have an example for the continuous random variable. We have been provided with the probability density function, and we have to find out the moment generating function. And if I see what is the real domain, we can say it's given as 0 to infinity, in which it is defined. And if x belongs to this interval 0 to infinity, the value is given by lambda e raised to power minus lambda x. This is how the function is defined. Let me show you how to find it out. We have the expected value of etx. This is the formula for the moment generating function. We are finding out the moment generating function for this function. So what we have to do, we have to replace it there in the formula and just integrate it. So here we have expected value given as minus infinity to infinity e raised to power tx fx dx. What we have written, the value of fx. Fx is given by lambda e raised to power minus lambda x. So if I put it here, and the limits have been changed because it is defined from 0 to 1. And if I take the limits, it becomes 0 to infinity e raised to power tx from first one. And the second one is lambda, so lambda is a constant that we can see is coming outside because it doesn't matter for x. And then from here we have e raised to power minus lambda x. Okay. So if I take x as common, it can be written as e raised to power x and in bracket t minus lambda. And if I integrate it, on integrating we are getting e raised to power x t minus lambda divided by t minus lambda, and the limit is from 0 to infinity. So, and thus on putting the limit, we are getting the expression lambda by lambda minus t, which is the required moment generating function. So if we have already worked upon the expected value, we know how to calculate the expectation of the different function using that properties, using the concept of integration and the formula that we have learned, we can calculate the moment generating functions. Okay, this is how we have done the example. Okay. The next question is in the continuation, that for this moment generating function, we have calculated moment generating function as lambda by lambda minus t. Now, the question is, can we calculate moments from this moment generating function? And if yes, how we can find out? Let's see. Here we are saying that now we are getting moment generating function as this. Correct? Now whenever the question is in front of you and we are looking for the moments to be generated, you have to see which formula or which method is better to find out the moments. As we have learned, one thing we have seen, that the coefficient of Tn by n factorial give me the value of the nth moment in the moment generating function. Next thing we have seen if we differentiate the moment generating function n times and put t is equal to 0, then it will give me the nth moment. So depending upon either the formula is already expanded or it is easy to find out the derivative of the formula, we have to choose one. As here in this case, we can see we have not obtained the expanded form. This is the moment generating function. And we know that it's very easy to find out the derivative of this type of function, and we have to find out moments. So how to find out the moments? Let's find out the first derivative, d by dt of mxt. I think all of you know how to find out the derivative of friction. So it is a p by q form. So here we have lambda minus t whole square.
Yep.
Lambda minus t into derivative of lambda gives me zero.
One upon t square.
Lambda by lambda minus t whole square. Correct? And if I put t as 0, because this is what the definition is saying, if I put t as 0, it will lead to lambda by lambda square, which gives me 1 by lambda. And this is our first moment generating function. And be sure to follow this example. Especially I have added, not from your book, because there it was not clear. But these are very much required when we are going to learn the moment generating function of the binomial, Poisson and normal distribution, which is specially mentioned in your course, along with the distributions. So there also we are going to work with the moment generating function formula again. Okay, this is just some of the example to make the concept. We are going to learn it again in the distribution chapters. So let's continue. And now here, this is the first moment. If we have to find out the second moment of x, how to find out? First derivative already we have calculated. What we have learned for finding out the nth derivative, for finding out the nth moment, we have to find out the nth derivative. So when we have to find out the second moment, what we have to take? We have to take the second derivative. Correct? The first derivative was lambda by lambda minus t whole square. Finding out the second derivative gives me 2 lambda by lambda minus t whole cube. Now this is what you have to do by yourself. Correct? So on verifying it, what we have to do? We have again to put this t as 0. If I put t as 0, it will become 2 lambda by lambda cube. And simplification gives me 2 by lambda square. So this is the second moment. Correct? And similarly, if I need more moments, the higher moments, I have to find out the derivative and put t is equal to 0. And I have to continue for the other moments. Correct? So this is one of the good example that I obtained for discussing that how to find out the moments from the moment generating function. One way is that if it's already expanded, we know what is the moment generating function, the expanded form. Take the coefficient of Tn by n factorial wherever it is occur, and that is the nth moment. Another way is what we have done. Moment generating function was given to us. We have actually calculated, and then we have obtained the first moment and second derivative. Second moment by finding out the derivative and putting t is equal to 0. Correct? Hope so you are getting it. Then we have another example for the Bernoulli's distribution, where the probability is given by p for x is equal to 1, it's 0 for 1 minus, for 0 it's 1 minus p, and otherwise it is 0. And what we are looking for? We are looking for the moment generating function of x if it exists. Okay? So you have to go through this by yourself. It is again the same terms. I'm not going to explain. Now you have to use your own logics. You have to go for it. How we are going to find out? Moment generating function is e of etx. And again, for this one value, we have this function. For zero value, we have this function. We have simplified and got this one. And then after, okay, I think we have not written the whole. We have not obtained the moments. We have just derived the moment generating function. So I think it's very easy to go for it. We have to use the formula as we have done in the starting. And from there, we will find out the moment generating function. This is when we have to find out the variance and the moment generating function is given. Now what here we have to do, we have to see how moment generating function and this variance are related. And if I think about it, then we will come to know that variance can be given as E of x square minus ex whole square. And what this ex square is? Ex square means the second moment. And this ex whose whole square is required, this is actually the first moment, correct? So variance can be calculated using this formula, where this is our second moment and this is our first moment. So what you have to do from this formula, you have to generate the first and the second moments, and then using it you have to find out the variance, correct? And this whole derivation is here, you have to go for it again and find out that the value should come 1/4. And I have not discussed the whole, I think so. You have to do it, otherwise you are not going to do anything. So be sure to work on it. How we are going to work on it? We have already discussed how to calculate the first derivative, the first moment, second derivative and the second moments. And I think it's very openly written over here how it works, and hence how to find out the variance. So this is left for you. You have to verify it and hence find out the variance of the example. Okay. So this is all from my side for today's lecture. And let me stop discussion. So go for it. And in case any doubts you are getting, you have to let me know. Thank you.